Hey everybody, Jason Bermas here reporting for WeAreChange.org, and today we're going to take a knee. You see, it's hard to get away from this now, and for those that don't know the history, this began with Colin Kaepernick taking a knee for Black Lives Matter. Now, I feel a lot of these issues are really police brutality issues and not race issues. In fact, I believe all lives matter. And I know some of you will call me a bigot for saying such things or say that I have white privilege, but the bottom line is this came down to individual decisions and individuals need to be held accountable. After the incident with Eric Garner, his family was asked what they thought and they refused to make it an issue about race and said, yes, this is a police brutality issue. Notice that fell right out of the news because that doesn't go with their narrative.
I feel that he was murdered unjustly. I don't even feel like it's a black and white thing, honestly. You know, in my opinion, I really don't feel like it's a black and white thing. And the police knew, you know, they knew. It wasn't like it was a shock. They knew. Mm-hmm. You know, they knew him by name. They harassed us. They said things to us.
This is not a black and white issue. This is a national crisis. Like, I believe that this is a crisis. I mean, for white people to come out and show how deeply they was hurt, and like Asians and, you know, different people from different nations.
You said this is not a black and white issue, but are you saying this is not an issue of race? I'm sure you think it's a racial issue?
I really doubt it. It was about the officer's pride. It was about my father being 6'4 and 350 pounds, and he wanted to be, you know, the top cop that brings this big man down because he's just big. I mean, my father wasn't even doing anything.
All that being said, I would like to say that it is okay to take a knee during the national anthem, and I know that's going to offend a lot of people. However, let me make my case. Ever since 9/11, all bets are off. Our government is no longer a constitutional republic for and by the people. It is a national security state run by corporate and banking interests. That's the truth. That's what's happening. So if you want to take a knee, hey, more power to you. But I'd like to point out that nobody was taking a knee for 9/11 truth. Nobody was taking a knee for no weapons of mass destruction in Iraq. Nobody is currently taking a knee for Afghanistan, for Syria, or even the threat of war with North Korea. You see, I feel that right now all of these NFL players that are taking a knee are taking a knee for a very selfish reason. They're taking a knee because the president called for a boycott on the NFL, and that's all it is. So basically, it comes down to greed, and then they're going to mask that into a racially divisive issue. It really does make me sick, folks, and I hope that most of us can see past this. Now, I understand that the national anthem is supposed to represent the best of the United States of America, a constitutional republic where we the people govern ourselves and every man, woman, and child is free and has the right to pursue happiness. But is that what we're currently living under? The fact of the matter is, if you believe that, you are a very, very naive person at this point. There are plenty of issues right now, both foreign and domestic, that need addressing, that need discussing. However, the media loves to feed into our sports-obsessed, celebritard culture, and the fact is, this isn't going to go anywhere. This is just going to get worse and worse, and the president is going to continue to play into this conflict, and it's very unfortunate.
Wouldn't you love to see one of these NFL owners, when somebody disrespects our flag, to say, get that son of a bitch off the field right now, out, he's fired. He's fired!
Because folks, are we really going to start dividing each other over a game, over football? I hope not. I hope people can see past this distraction and continue to search for the truth and continue to push for a better government, for Trump to deliver on his better promises instead of continuing aggression in the Middle East and really not doing much domestically at this point either. As always, if you like this video, please subscribe, share on social media, and follow me at Jason Bermas. And go check out WeAreChange.org. It's only through your financial support that reports like this one are possible.